Hey guys. So I'm at the fifth hive. It's a single deep. It was a split. And I'm just giving it a quick check to see if they have progressed, if they'll need a second box or if they're going to need a super, depending on what way I want to do it. I'd like to get the majority of them into double deeps for winter, but we'll see how it goes. I have upset a few of them, to say the least, so I'm just gonna wear the gloves. I gave them a little smoke a minute ago, so their bellies should be full. I know I did a little checkerboarding before I left. This is old comb. As you can see, I don't have a lot of comb, so that's, I'm sure a lot of you would know. I'm in the hole, I'm trying to get out. Started this one, that's good. It's not completely drawn down to the bottom, but better than nothing. I'm going to turn this frame around to try to encourage them to draw this side a little faster. Procedure capped. Looking at three cups there. It's a really strong frame of brood too. It's almost wall to wall. Side is good too. Nothing, but I need to make sure that they're queen right, so I'm just gonna this frame here. Or not. nectar. We're drawing it slowly, but it's nectar. I'm not sure this next frame is going to be very promising. I'm seeing nectar. Here's another capped cell. One, two, three, four, five, six. I don't know what is happening with queens, but this is not the first time this has happened to me. Before we left to go on holidays a week ago, I found 10 supersedures in a really strong hive at Stillwater Farm. And I made a split. I made two splits and left three. Three supersedures in the original hive. So I have to get back there today to see, had the queens got out? Have they been successful on their mating flight? I mean, it doesn't look like it could be long ago. I mean, well, yeah, there's no queen in this hive. There's just nectar. Nectar and honey right now, so I'm not going to interfere too much with this one. I'm just going to let them duel it out, because yeah, it's nectar. The nectar and honey, they're getting ready to cap, and whatever remaining brood, I'm sure when they emerge, to fill those cells back with nectar also. So I'm not going to make any splits out of this one to try to, you know, save some of them. I'm just going to let them duel it out and let the best female win. I'll come back to this one in 10 days. See if there's a laying queen. Thanks for watching, guys. If you haven't, please like and subscribe. Catch you next time.